Hello guys, Life Hackster here. Today we'll be checking out the dome camera from EZVIZ. I did review their 1080p indoor cam, the C1C, a while back, and I actually liked it that I'm still using it right now. I ruffled some feathers then when I said that the C1C is better than the Wisecam. Well, I can tell you that as to video quality and also to the responsiveness, which the camera loads up pretty fast when viewing live view, and also there is barely any latency. And still, this camera is only $24.95 at Amazon. So this camera is a definite contender to the Wisecam. But remember, I also and still like my Wisecams. I will link down below my review video, which you will also see the comparison footage to the Wise camera. So today, we will check out the EZVIZ Pan and Tilt Dome Camera, the C6CN. We will do the unboxing, check out its features, show you the video and audio quality, and see if this Pan and Tilt camera is a good choice for your needs. First, the price. EZVIZ sells this dome camera at Amazon for $39.95. It is a full HD 1080p camera that has a 94 degrees diagonal field of view. It has a 340 degrees pan and 105 degrees up and 15 degrees down tilt. It can record up to 22 frames per second, but this will depend on the network speed, which in my testing, it was only recording at 15 FPS. And just a comparison, the C1C records at 20 FPS. It has night vision of up to 33 feet. It has smart tracking where when it detects motion, it will automatically track its motion and keep it centered in the frame. It has a privacy shutter which it will flip up and cover the camera lens for maximum privacy. And this is controlled in the app. It has full duplex two-way audio. You can control and view the cameras across multiple platforms, like on your smartphone using the app, and you can also view the camera on a PC using the EZVIZ PC Studio. As to storage options, it can record locally using a microSD card, which it supports up to 256GB card. Cloud storage, which you will need a monthly subscription, or you can use the EZVIZ NVR. Time to open up the box. We have the camera itself, which the head part is bigger than the base. I'm not really fond of the design. We have the lens, light sensor, and infrared LEDs in the front. So it tilts 105 degrees up and down 15 degrees. And the head rotates and pans 340 degrees. We have the status LED and the EZVIZ branding in the front of the base. On the side, we have the speaker. At the back, we have an Ethernet port if you want to directly connect this to your network. I'll use Wi-Fi in this setup, and a micro USB port for power. Here's a quick comparison with the C1C model, which I reviewed a few weeks back. What else is inside the box? We have a thank you card. We have the quick start guide. We have some mounting screws and plastic anchors. We have the power adapter, 5 volts and 1 amp. We have a mounting plate if you want to install this on a wall or ceiling. We have a drilled template for the mounting plate. Lastly, we have a 10-foot micro USB cable. Time to set this up. Plug in the power supply to the back of the camera. Download, sign up, and open up the EZVIZ app. On the upper right corner, click the plus sign icon. Click OK for the app to access your camera so that you can scan the QR code which is located at the bottom of the camera. Tap device is powered on and click next. When the status light flashes blue, check the button and click next. Type in your Wi-Fi's password and click next. And wait until the camera is connected. The live view then loads up. Time to check out the settings in the app. When you open up the app, you will see your EZVIZ cameras. Tap the gear icon to get into the camera settings. We have the toggle switches for the audio, status light, and infrared LEDs on or off. We have alarm notification where you can turn it on and set the notification schedule. You can choose the motion detection area, and this is pixel-based motion detection. And you will have a grid where you can customize areas you want the motion to be monitored. Or you can use the eraser to delete the zones. Just a clarification on how I set my indoor cameras, like this camera or any other cameras that I currently use, like my Wisecams and also my Yi Dome camera. I don't turn on notifications unless we are going to be out of the house for longer periods of time, like when we are out on a vacation. I also don't use or subscribe to their cloud recordings. All of them have microSD cards and records locally. I use them more as a backup and for live viewing. So your use might be different than mine. Pixel-based detection is not accurate in motion detection as compared to PIR or AI type of detection. Changes in light and shadows will trigger pixel-based systems. We have motion sensitivity where you can choose from 0 to 6. Then we have an alarm mode. The camera has a siren where you can choose soft, which it beeps whenever it senses motion. Or you can use intensive where a quick short siren will go off. The siren can only be set to go off when it detects motion. Then we have the time zone and date format. Wi-Fi, cloud storage if you want to sign up with the EZVIZ Cloud Play, which I will not use in this setup because I will install a microSD card for my recordings. To install a microSD card, tilt the lens up until you see a tab that says microSD and reset. Flip the cover open and you will see the microSD card slot and the reset switch. Just insert your microSD card and push it in until it clicks. Going back to the main app page, click on the camera to get to live view. Click the square icon to pause live view. Speaker to mute the audio. Grid icon is where you can stream your other EZVIZ cameras. And the video quality of the stream from standard, high definition, and ultra HD. Don't confuse the ultra HD with 4K. This camera's resolution is only up to 1080p. And we have the full screen icon. On the second row, we have the pan and tilt icon where you can manually pan and tilt the camera. We also have the 360 degree picture if you want the camera to take a 360 panoramic shot. And the auto tracking where the camera will follow the motion, and we will test this later on. We have the mic to start two-way audio. Just tap the mic one time and it is full duplex. Then we have the privacy mode, which when turned on, the camera lens will tilt up all the way and will get covered to have the assurance that the camera is not and will not be able to see and record. Then we have the camera icon to take a snapshot of the current view and the video icon to record. This will be saved to your phone's album. Now time to check out the camera's video and audio quality.
So this is the video and audio quality of the EZVIZ C6CN. And this is daytime and my blinds are open. So this is the video and audio quality of the EZVIZ C6CN. So this is the video quality of the EZVIZ C6CN dome camera at night and with the infrared LEDs on, and it's totally dark. So this is what it looks like, and this is what it looks like when I'm close to the camera. And this is what it looks like when I'm away from the camera. So this is what it looks like when the camera is tracking me. Thank you.
So we are going to test the motion alert notification speed of the EZVIZ C6CN dome camera, and I'm on my LTE connection. And the mode is set to soft mode, which is you will hear a tone. So let's check it out. Hear that? It's the tone. And I got the notification. And when you click on that, you will get a thumbnail. And then you can click playback and you will see what started the motion. Now I've set the mode to intensive, and you will hear this short siren when it detects motion. So let's check it out. So what do you think, guys? Personally, the only reason that I'll be installing a dome pan and tilt camera is when I want to be able to pan and view in real time. I usually don't use the auto tracking feature because it draws attention to the camera. And when the camera moves following a subject, it just creates a blur, lessening the chances of getting a clear footage. They also will usually have a narrow field of view as compared to a regular static camera. So if you have activated the motion tracking, you will have instances, especially if there's motion on the edges of the field of view, that the camera will only choose one to follow, and you will lose the view of the other motion. I prefer to have just two static cameras and should cover the same field of view of a dome camera. Any questions? Comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. And click the little bell icon so that you'll get notified when I upload product reviews like this video, product updates, comparison videos, and long-term reviews. Thank you.